Hello, welcome to part 16. I didn't realise that it was ending that quickly. So, welcome to part 16 of a playthrough of Metro Last Light. Good point there for listening to the plan.
A frontal assault is hopeless, but if we go underground to the church, advance through the catacombs, then attack from the rear, we should encounter little or no resistance. Then we just have to do a sweep.
Attention! Comrade General!
Soldiers, you are trusted with an important mission. Each group has its task, and you have been told only what you need to know to succeed. But remember, that this operation is top secret, and you must not be taken alive by the enemy. I hope that I am understood. Questions?
Can we use radios after we capture the assigned targets?
Only in case of emergency, and on a scrambled frequency.
If we're faced with strong enemy counterattacks, do we hold the positions or fall back?
Hold them. Anyway, the enemy is unlikely to mount an effective counteroffensive.
Comrade General, we have been issued a banner along with the other gear, but we were also made to remove all our markings.
We will leave no trace of our operation. Only upon victory and receipt of the following signal will you raise your banner over the captured target. Further questions?
No, Comrade General.
Good luck, then.
Surrender! Line!
Wanker.
Now I am in the real spider-infested catacombs, where the General Secretary Moskvin does not look like the head spider. That title clearly belongs to General Korbut. I sure would like to know what's on his mind. What did Lesnitsky bring him from D6? What's going to destroy the enemies of the revolution? Only questions and no answers. The only thing that is clear, Pavel has information on the Dark One, which makes him my current target.
Thank you for watching part 16, and I'll see you in part 17.